G'day everybody, today we're taking a look at creating waypoints and routes in Garmin Explore and uploading them to Navigate. First of all, you'll see here I'm logging on to the Garmin Explore website. I've already created myself an account and created myself a home point. So the next thing that we're going to do is show you how to create a waypoint in the app itself. We're doing this search manually. So we've created a point here and we're navigating to it on the map. You'll see here you just need to create a little plus sign to make a waypoint and click the green tick when you're done. Every time you update something, you'll get a pop-up asking you to update on the app as well. You'll see up the top here there's also a little flag where you can actually just create a manual waypoint and just pin drop on the map. The next thing we're going to do now is take a look at creating ourselves a route. What we're doing is creating a route for an upcoming trip that we're doing out to Uluru. So what I'm doing now is just starting down in Badesert and creating a couple of points on the map. Now you will notice here that we're just going as the crow flies when we drop points on the map. What will happen later on when you actually upload this to the device itself, it'll snap to roads. So we've created ourselves a route there quite easily, just selected on the endpoint to finish the route. So you'll see now that route is now in our library under routes, and if you want to actually adjust or create additional destinations on this existing route, all you need to do is just select the route itself, and what you'll see there is some handles that will actually appear on the route itself. So if you want to create little waypoints or little points of interest along the way on your route, just drag those little handles. It's really quite easy to do. And once you're done, once again, just select the little tick and save route. And once again, you'll get a sync reminder, as you always do, to upload to your device. So now we've got a fairly simple route. What we're gonna do is just edit this existing route. You'll see here there's details on renaming the route if you like, and you can drag handles all the way along the route. Or if you want to add different towns or different points along the way, it's really, really easy to do so. What we're going to do now is create a secondary route. So what I'm doing is creating this secondary route as a second day drive, for example. So we're just doing the same as we did with the first route, just going from one town to the next town, down to Dubbo here, and then further along the map. And as with the creation of the first route, if we want to add or adjust this, we can do so later on along the way, after you've uploaded it to the device. And you can actually adjust your trail or your points on your access route on the device as it's completed. We're only just doing it here on the PC just because it's easy and we happen to be in front of the computer while we're looking up different destinations and places we intend on going along the way in our journey. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button below and enable notifications so I can keep you up to date with any new content as it comes out. Alright, so we've selected the endpoint now and we've finished editing on this particular route. We've put a couple of different waypoints along the way here at Wilcannia, for example, and we've saved route. Once again, you get the usual syncing reminder. So already, in the space of a couple of minutes, we've already got a couple of days worth of trails already done. Alright, now what we're going to do now is create a collection on the Garmin Explore app. What we're trying to do in this example here is trying to create an entire trip. So what I'm doing is creating a new collection now. I'm calling it Uluru Trip, and you'll see underneath I can select day one and day two. If I'd done any other tracks along the way, I could add those in as well. I may have had 5 or 6 different days worth of tracks done. I can add them in all in. Now you can make this collection visible on MapShare if you want to have other people access the collection as well. It's quite easy to do so. And as usual, you'll get the usual sync reminder. When you actually do sync your device, it syncs wirelessly, so it syncs really, really quickly. And as we've seen in the previous video, there's a magnetic connector to the vehicle to get the Overlander in and out of the vehicle, so it's really easy to get in and out. Bring it inside, put it next to your computer, it's synced in a couple minutes and it's done really easily. So we're just checking under the collection items here. What this is giving us is waypoints in our collection. You've got the option here to add more waypoints to the collection. So for example, if you wanted to go to another place along the way and someone had given you the name of a place that you wanted to check out, you could add another waypoint to your collection. It's really simple to do, and what we've done here, waypoint was a little bit difficult and we couldn't find it on the map very well. We've manually added it in. So I've added it as a waypoint and we've added it to our route here just by dragging the handles on our day one journey out to that particular point. What that's going to do is it'll snap it to the road once the device has been synced up. So that's added that in as another waypoint for us. So we've now got 2 waypoints on our day one journey, and if we go back to our collection now, you'll see that waypoint has now added itself to the collection. You can actually also manually add other waypoints in if you want to. You've got plenty of different ways to do different things at various times in this particular app. It's not all that confusing. You just have plenty of options and it's really, really user friendly. So that's the thing I really enjoy about using it. It's really quite user friendly. All right, well this particular journey is shaping up now. We've got a couple of different waypoints along the way, and what we're gonna do now is take a look at syncing it up. All right, so what we're gonna do now is just sync the device itself. Because I'm actually doing some software updates and map updates, I've got the device plugged into power, but as I mentioned earlier, the device itself will sync to the Garmin app on your computer via your Wi-Fi, which is actually really simple to do. But we're just taking a quick look here at adding some updates while it's plugged in. All right, so now that we've updated the map from the Garmin Explore app, we're just going to jump into Explore on the device. That's going to bring up our map view. And we're just going to go quickly into Library now. First of all, you'll see the waypoints that we added previously. They've now been updated to the device. And what we're actually looking for is the trip collection. You'll see down the bottom here, it's in Collections. So we're going to go to collection, and there it is, and we're going to start on day one. Now there is a lot more in-depth information that you can get on all of your journeys. It's a little too complicated to go into at this stage. All I really wanted to do is just sort of focus on a beginning creation of a journey, just so you can get a look at what it looks like, how to create a journey. And if you'd like to get any information on the higher functioning parts of the device, just let me know and I'll do a video at a later date and show you through all of those. There are a whole heap of other settings here that we won't actually use. You'll see here we can edit from here if we like as well. So there it is there, it's starting. We just hit go. Because we're not actually at the entry point or the start point that I calculated, we have to just go to the nearest entry point. This comes into play if you're using four-wheel drive routes and other things later on also. So it just took a second there to calculate, and there we are. We're up and running, we can start. And what we had earlier, where we were just looking at the points on the map only. You'll now see in Street View when we zoom out that all of those points are now following roads along. So the whole process was actually really, really simple, quite easy to follow and not as difficult as you might think. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share the channel. I greatly appreciate it. We'll see you next time we get four wheels on the road.